Hello students, welcome to the EPG Pathshala. I am Dr. Rajeshwari Sinha, working as Program Officer at the Center for Science and Environment in New Delhi. Today in this lecture, we are going to learn about operons. The objectives of this lecture will be to understand how gene is expressed and regulated in prokaryotic organisms, to understand the regulation of lactose utilization in E. coli, to understand regulation of tryptophan biosynthesis, and also to look at regulation of arabinose metabolisms in E. coli. This shows the concept map that will be followed in this lecture. We will see how the lac operon and TRP operon combine together to bring about gene expression and regulation. We will also see the effects of positive and negative regulation. The genome is divided into sequences of DNA known as genes that have specific functions. Genes that code for proteins are known as structural genes or cistrons. Other genes which have regulatory functions and act to control the expression of the structural genes. By controlling which of the genes of the organisms are to be converted into functional enzymes, the cell regulates its metabolic activities. Some regions of DNA are specifically involved in regulating transcription, and these regulatory genes can control the synthesis of specific enzymes. Some enzymes are synthesized only when the cell requires them. Such enzymes are inducible or repressible. Several enzymes that have related functions are controlled by the same regulatory genes. Operons. An operon is a DNA sequence that codes for one or more polypeptides, usually of related function, and a DNA sequence that regulates the expression of these genes. Induction and repression are based on regulatory genes producing a regulator protein that controls transcription by binding to a specific site of DNA. Regulation of transcription may be under negative control when mRNA for a particular set of genes are synthesized unless it is turned off by the regulatory protein. There are differences from bacterial operons, however, in that clusters of genes in the archaeal chromosome contain internal promoters and terminators. The promoters in bacterial cells are upstream of the operator region and not within the operons. Also, the transcripts produced from an operon in bacterial cells are of uniform length and always code for the full complement of proteins of the operons. The transcripts of archaeal operons are of varying length and may code for only some of the proteins in the operons. Alternatively, transcriptional regulation of a different set of genes may be under positive control where mRNA is synthesized only in the presence of a regulatory protein that binds to the DNA. Archaeal genes with coordinated functions are clustered as they are in bacterial cells. Lac operon. Based on data arising from genetic studies, Jacob and Monod proposed the operon model in 1961 to explain the phenomenon of induction. One of the best studied regulatory system concerns the enzymes produced by E. coli strain K12 for the metabolism of lactose. Three enzymes are specifically synthesized by E. coli for the metabolism of lactose. These are beta-galactosidase, galactosides permease, thiogalactoside transacetylase. The structural genes that code for the production of these three enzymes occur in a contiguous segment of the DNA which code for polycistronic DNA. The operon for lactose metabolism, the lac operon, includes a promoter region P where RNA polymerase binds, a regulatory region I that codes for the synthesis of a repressor protein, an operator region O that occurs between the promoter and the three structural genes involved in lactose metabolism. The inducer of the lac operon, allolactase, binds to the repressor protein and alters the conformation of the repressor protein. It acts as an allosteric effector and therefore it is unable to interact with and bind at the operator region. Thus, in the presence of an inducer that binds with the repressor protein, transcription of lac operon is depressed and the synthesis of three structural proteins needed for lactose metabolism proceeds. As the lactose is metabolized and its concentration diminished, the concentration of the derivative allolactose produced from lactose by low levels of beta-galactosidase also declines, making it unavailable for binding with the repressor protein. Thus, active repressor protein molecules are again available for binding at the operator region, and the transcription of the lac operon is repressed, ceasing further production of the enzymes involved in lactose metabolism that are controlled by this regulatory region of the DNA. Under normal conditions, the lac operon is repressed and transcription of lactose utilization genes occurs. Control of the lac operon is complex. There are three operator regions in the lac operon designated as O1, O2 and O3. The principal operator is O1. O2 is located 400 base pairs downstream from O1. O3 is located 93 base pairs upstream from O1. All three operators are required for maximal gene expression. Binding of the repressor to the oppressor distorts the conformation of the DNA so that it bends away from the repressor. This alters the grooves of the DNA double helix and is responsible for the change in efficiency of the transcription. Additionally, activation of the lac operon involves a cyclic AMP-dependent activator protein that, in the presence of high concentrations of cyclic AMP, increases transcription by binding to a recognition site on the DNA adjacent to the location of the RNA polymerase attachment. The structure of the tetrameric repressor suggests that it acts with the catabolite gene activator protein and forms repression loops in which one tetrameric repressor interacts simultaneously with two sites on the DNA. We have now reached midway into this lecture. So far, we understood what are operons and saw examples of some operons which are associated with gene expression and gene regulation. These are lac operon, TRP operon, and the arabinose operon. We looked at the lac operon in detail. In the next section, we will first understand what is catabolite repression. Then we will also look at the other two operons and their involvement in gene regulation in more detail. Catabolite repression. When E. coli grows in a medium that contains glucose and lactose, it does not utilize both sugars at the same time. Instead, it preferentially utilizes glucose first until that sugar is depleted and only then switches to the utilization of lactose as the carbon source. This results in a biphasic pattern of growth known as dioxic growth. In the first phase of growth on glucose, the genes that code for the enzymes that metabolize lactose are shut off. After glucose depletion, there is a lag phase in growth during which the genes that code for the enzymes that metabolize lactose are turned on and are transcribed and translated into proteins. Then the cells can resume optimal growth using lactose, the mechanism that allows bacteria to discriminate between utilization of two different carbon sources is largely due to catabolite repression. In the presence of adequate concentration of glucose, some catabolite pathways are repressed by catabolite repression, including those involved in the metabolism of lactose, galactose, and arabinose. When glucose is available for catabolism in the glycolytic pathway, other monosaccharide and disaccharides need not be used by the cell to generate ATP, and by blocking the metabolism of these other carbohydrates, the cell conserves its metabolic resources. Catabolic repression is an example of regulation by positive control. It acts via the promoter region of DNA and by doing so complements the control exerted by the operator region. The efficient binding of the RNA polymerase to promoter regions subject to catabolite repression requires the presence of a catabolite activator protein, also called CAMP receptor protein. In the absence of the CAP, the RNA polymerase had a greatly decreased affinity to bind to the promoter region. The CAP in turn cannot bind to the promoter region unless it is bound to the CAMP. There is an inverse relationship between the concentration of CAMP and ATP, in which levels of CAMP respond to the state of cellular metabolism. Molecules of CAMP are formed from ATP by the enzyme adenyl cyclase. Intracellular levels of CAMP are low when rapidly metabolizable substrates such as glucose are used. Under these conditions, the cap is not able to bind at the promoter region. Consequently, RNA polymerase are unable to bind to catabolite repressible promoters, and transcription at a number of regulated structural genes ceases in a coordinated manner. In the absence of glucose, there is an adequate supply of CAMP to permit the binding of RNA polymerase to the promoter region. Thus, when glucose levels are low, CAMP stimulates the initiation of many inducible enzymes. The TRP operon. Regulatory genes can be shut off under specific conditions. Such repressible operons control specific biosynthetic pathways. For example, the TRP operon, which contains the genes that codes for the proteins required for biosynthesis of the amino acid tryptophan, is responsible. There are 5 structural genes in the TRP operon that are responsible for the synthesis of 5 enzymes. As with other operons, there is also an operator region, a promoter region, and a gene that codes for a regulator protein in the TRP operon. The TRP repressor protein is normally inactive and unable to bind at the operator region, but tryptophan can act as an allosteric effector or co-repressor. In the presence of excess tryptophan, the TRP repressor protein binds with tryptophan and as a result is also able to bind to the TRP operator region. When the TRP repressor protein tryptophan complex binds at the TRP operator region, the transcription of the enzymes involved in the biosynthesis of the tryptophan is repressed. In the case of negative control by the TRP operon, tryptophan acts as a repressor substance that shuts off the biosynthetic pathway for its own synthesis when there is a sufficient supply of tryptophan. There is an example of end product repression, the process of shutting off transcription by the genes in that operon. When the level of tryptophan in the cell declines, there is insufficient tryptophan to act as a co-repressor and the transcription of the genes for the biosynthesis of tryptophan resumes. The TRP operon is typical of anabolic pathways where in the presence of a sufficient supply of biosynthetic product of the pathway, the system is repressed. Attenuation, regulation of transcription by translation. Attenuation is a mode of regulating gene expression in which events that occur during translation affect the transcription of an operon region of the DNA. As indicated earlier, translation in bacteria and archaea normally begins before transcription of the mRNA is completed, with the leader portion of mRNA attaching to the ribosome and translation beginning before the complete mRNA is transcribed. The leader sequence in bacterial cells occurs between the operator and the first structural genes. In the first case of the TRP operon, there is an attenuator site between the operator region and the first structural gene of the operon where the transcription can be interrupted. Whether or not the termination occurs is determined by the secondary structure of the mRNA at the attenuator region. There are 2 possible structures of mRNA. In one form, mRNA folds to establish a double-stranded region known as terminator hairpin that causes termination of transcription. The particular structure that forms depends on the availability of tryptophan because this is one amino acid which is coded for the leader sequence. When tryptophan is available for incorporation into proteins, the peptide sequence coded for this leader sequence can be successfully translated. When tryptophan reaches very low concentrations, translation is delayed as the leader codons that code for the insertion of tryptophan into the polypeptide. This is sufficient tryptophan and charged tryptophile tRNA are not available. When the translation process is slowed, mRNA is in the form that permits transcription to proceed through entire sequence of TRP operon. However, if there is sufficient tryptophan to permit rapid translation to proceed through attenuator site, The mRNA forms the terminator hairpin structure, and further transcription of the TRP operon ceases so that none of the structural genes for tryptophan metabolism are transcribed. Positive regulation, the arabinose operon. Ellis Engelsberg demonstrated the metabolism of arabinose in E. coli and concluded that arabinose operon was regulated in a positive manner. The ARA operon codes for three enzymes required to catalyze the metabolism of arabinose: arabinose isomerase, ribulokinase, ribulo-5-phosphate epimerase. The three structural genes are arranged in an operon that is regulated by the ARA-C gene product. There are four important regulatory sites as shown in the diagram. ARA-O1 is an operator site. ARA-C binds to this site and represses its own transcription from the PC promoter. In the presence of arabinose, ARA-C bound at this site helps to activate expression of the PBAD promoter. ARA-O2 is also an operator site. ARA-C bound at this site can simultaneously bind to the ARA-1 site to repress transcription from the PBAD promoter. ARA-O2 is also an operator site. ARA-C bound at this site can simultaneously bind to the ARA-I site to repress transcription from the PBAD promoter. ARA-I is also the inducer site. ARA-C bound at this site can simultaneously bind to the ARA-O2 site to repress transcription from the PBAD promoter. In the presence of arabinose, however, ARA-C bound at this site helps to activate the expression of the PBAD promoter. CRP binds to the CRP binding site. It does not directly assist RNA polymerase to bind to the promoter in this case. Instead, in the presence of arabinose, it promotes the rearrangement of ARA-C when arabinose is present from a state in which it represses transcription of the PBAD promoter to one in which it activates the transcription of the PBAD promoter. Regulation of the arabinose operon is clearly much more complex than lactose operon. When arabinose is absent, there is no need to express the structural genes. ARA-C does this by binding simultaneously to ARA-I and ARA-O2. As a result, the intervening DNA is looped. These two events block access to the PBAD promoter, which is in any case a very weak promoter. ARA-C also prevents its own expression. Thus, it is an autoregulator of its own expression. This makes sense. There is no need to overexpress ARA-C. If the concentration falls too low, then transcription of ARA-C resumes until the amount of ARA-C is sufficient to prevent more transcription again. When arabinose is present, it binds to ARA-C and allosterically induces it to bind to ARA-I instead of ARA-O2. If glucose is also absent, then the presence of the ARA operon demonstrates both negative and positive control. It shows a different function for CRP. It also shows how a protein can act as a switch, with its activity being radically altered upon the binding of a small molecule. RP bound to its site between ARA-O1 and ARA-I helps to break the DNA loop and also helps ARA-C to bind to ARA-I. Students, we have now come to the end of this lecture. Today, we learnt what are operons, what are their functions, and also saw how different operons work. Let us briefly summarize what we have learnt today in this lecture. An operon is a DNA sequence that codes for one or more polypeptides, usually of related functions, and a DNA sequence that regulates the expression of these genes. The operon for lactose metabolism, the lac operon, includes a promoter region, a regulatory gene, and an operator region. When glucose is available for catabolism in the glycolytic pathway, other monosaccharides and disaccharides need not be used by the cell to generate ATP. And by blocking the metabolism of these other carbohydrates, the cell tends to conserve its metabolic resources. This is what is known as catabolite repression. Catabolite repression is an example of a regulation by positive control. The TRP operon contains the genes that code for the enzymes required for the biosynthesis of the amino acid tryptophan. There are five structural genes in the TRP operon that are responsible for the synthesis of five enzymes. There is also an operator region, a promoter region, and a gene that codes for a regulator protein in the TRP operon. The arabinose operon is associated with the metabolism of arabinose in E. coli. This operon codes for three enzymes that are required to catalyze the metabolism of arabinose, namely arabinose isomerase, ribulokinase, and ribulose 5-phosphate epimerase. Regulation of the arabinose operon is clearly much more complex than the lactose operon. Thank you for watching this lecture on operons.